Hi, what can I do when dog will, wait, what can I do when dog will something commands with prong collar, but if I take prong collar off, she ignores command. Oh, she's getting collar.
Yeah. So how long have you been working on it? A month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, a year? And have you corrected your dog? Have you said no and then corrected? Does the dog know what the word no means? So a lot of times people don't work on commands long enough. So when we do food training, your average dog that's food trained only in obedience, it takes 4,000 repetitions to become complicit in the command. 4,000 repetitions. It's a lot of freaking repetitions. Next. Hey, everybody. How are you? We're live. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It is Monday night. Get trying to get the camera, angle here.
Oh, well, that works.
Great. Works. So my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is Linda. We're married. She doesn't do anything about the dogs. So she's my co-host historically on Monday nights. Monday nights, we do a 1 hour show from 8:30 to 9:30 PM Eastern Standard Time. Everybody on Spotify, SoundCloud, on Google, on iHeartRadio, and all my other Alexa and all my other sound platforms. Hi, how are you? For everybody watching on YouTube Live, of course, have a good evening. We'll see you tonight for the next hour. I've got a board and train facility up in Providence, Rhode Island. We specialize in aggression rehab and behavior modification. We work with a lot of challenging dogs. I personally travel the world doing dog training seminars. We've got 20 scheduled for 2019. Florida is coming up and Seattle is coming up. You can go to jeffgelmanseminars.com for that. Most of what we do in our training center is rehab dogs. The show, though, is a lot of how do I stop? If you're brand new to my world, you're going to hear the word punishment a lot on the show. Almost after every question, you'll hear the word punishment historically because people are asking how to stop an unwanted behavior. The only way to stop an unwanted behavior is through the proper application of punishment. Punishment is not abuse. Anybody that says that it is isn't familiar with how to do it. So we actually do tons of reward-based training. We won't talk science in this show because nobody understands it. And frankly, people don't give a shit. At least my clients don't. They want problems fixed. So here we go. There's a dollar sign down at the bottom. Dollar, make you holler. It says show your support for Solid Canine Training. It's something YouTube does for their content creators. And it's great. Your question goes to the top of the queue. Yesterday's show, we actually left about 30 questions we couldn't answer. We ran out of time, and I apologize for that. So tonight, I'll try to go a little bit quicker. We'll see what we can do. Most questions need a very long answer. I'm just giving you a short answer, but there's other platforms that I have. Instagram and IG Stories. You can check out us on our IG Stories. There's a little AMA there. Just go to our Instagram account, go to Stories, look for Ask Me Anything. Oh. You can actually fill out the little sticker there. And then also on my Patreon channel, patreon.com/solidcaninetraining. You'll get a very long response to that. And then obviously Skype. Don't forget, get your What Would Jeff Do swag. We've got stickers. We've got pop sockets.
Pop that socket.
Pop sockets. And we've got t-shirts and hats coming. Go to whatwouldjeffdo.com. Here we go. Let's go, Linda.
This one's from Mike. Good evening. Lots of work put in with the prong collar the past month. Tons of progress. Still have major leash reaction when other dogs are near, even on the other side of the fence.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. At that point, she doesn't care about the prong. We are trying to catch it early, but it's not working. We'll keep fighting the good fight.
Good. So it's not that she doesn't care about the prong. She doesn't care about anything except for getting the other dog. So what you need to do is I would add a remote collar to the mix. A remote collar, shock collar, is one of the most fantastic tools out there for leash reactive dogs. And your timing will be better. It's more powerful. It's better communication. It has more meaning to the dog. And you're always gonna struggle at some point with some leash reactivity. But boy, is that gonna make a big, big difference. Also, what you can do is try my 180 move. Watch it on my YouTube channel, which you're on now. Just search for it. Do it at the beginning of the walk. So literally do a higher level correction before the dog even is thinking about being reactive. And these are on dogs that are leash reactive. That's the philosophy. Next.
This one's from Dennis.
Hey, Dennis.
We are owners of a cane corso, fairly new to your videos. Do you have a playlist from beginning puppyhood, properly raising a, a canine, I understand that different dogs have personalities as well.
So no, I don't. All my free stuff is not categorized. It's a hodgepodge. It looks like a flea market. It's the way my mind works. So that's where my Skypes come in. Skypes come in, you know, up into, you know, a lot of, if it's literally a puppy right now, tons of food training and lots of structure. But as far as different dogs have different personalities, not that much different unless you're doing, so I'm a pet dog trainer. Let's all keep that in mind. So pet dogs, I treat almost all pet dogs the same. Obviously, there's small nuances, but pretty much I'm not doing sport. I'm not doing trick. I'm not doing agility. I'm not doing search and rescue. I'm not doing bite work. I'm not doing odor work. I'm just a pet dog trainer. So for a family pet, a lot of the training across the board for most of the breeds and most of the personalities are pretty similar. Next.
Jenna, congrats on number 500. Love you guys and everything you do. Thank you so much for the info and advice.
You're welcome. Thank you. And I think the 500 is just since we've been keeping track. I think it's way higher. Yeah. It's way higher than that. So, but anyway, but yeah, 500 documented right now. So awesome. Cool.
This one's from Audrey.
Hey, Audrey.
Hi, Jeff. Thank you for your advice on getting help with my dog's back/spine issue. We've had several affordable visits and we're back playing Chuck It. Much love to you and your team.
Awesome. Good for you, Audrey. Yeah. I mean, if you get a good acupuncture, canine massage, chiropractor, I mean, it makes a humongous difference. I remember when Uma, who's dead now, she couldn't move her back leg. She was actually dragging. After her first acupuncture visit, she was walking. I was just like, you've got to be kidding me. And then after a second acupuncture visit, she was hurling herself into the swimming pool like she normally does. I was blown away. Next.
Audrey also said happy birthday and happy number 500 also.
Thank you so much.
This one's from Noel. Happy birthday, Jeff. Congrats on number 500.
Oh, hey, Noel. How are you? I'll be out in Indiana coming up. See you then. Next.
Lil Mama Mud. Hello from cold ass Canada. Blizzards is in full swing. Temps falling into the negative 30s with wind chill low 40s.
Yep.
Bonking the cat more than the dog on day 4 of zero attitude.
Good for you.
And happy birthday.
Thank you so much. Yeah. If anybody is complaining about the cold, go see where Rebecca lives. Next. Take care.
I'm going to stop complaining.
Yeah, you should.
Karen, wanted to update you on my dog Max without addition of the 1.5-year-old Italian Mastiff King Corso. They're doing great. The Mastiff is very submissive and a huge baby.
Nice.
Hit send too fast. Big thanks for the advice. They did great just existing around one another.
Existence is great, Karen. Keep it up. Love you. That's fantastic. It's great, great, great to hear.
Okay, we have another Karen, which is GSD Lover. Yep. Hope you had a happy birthday, Jeff. High stim on e-collar stopped many unwanted behaviors. They all returned after a month. Is this usual? Was the connection not enough? What am I missing? Thanks.
Do it again. So you got a month. I'll take it, right? That's not bad. So let's say once a month, you have to remind the dog not to do something again. So big deal. How long does it take to give that correction? 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds? Do it again. It's called life. This is the thing. Can you put an inhibitor into a dog that lasts forever? Yeah, sure you can. It's I do. Are there some other things that you've got to remind the dog once in a while? Absolutely. Absolutely. But the way I look at it is this, who cares? Remind them. And don't let anybody tell you, well, that it wasn't good training if you have to keep doing it in a month. Really? Okay. Tell that to somebody that has to go to therapy 3 times a week, once a week, once a month. Tell them that. No, it doesn't work that way. If you got to do it once a month, so be it. Next.
This one's from Jeff the Chef. Hi, Jeff. I've been working my dog on the mini educator for about a week now. His recall is damn near 100% already. Cool. When should I start to phase out of hitting the remote when I call him? Thank you.
Stop. Start now. So stop prompting. Now just hold your dog accountable for non-compliance. But keep the dog, make sure the dog is, you might want to have a long line on the dog. Because what you're doing now is you're prompting at a low level, holding the dog accountable for non-compliance is at a higher level. And you want to make sure your dog doesn't freak out. You want to make sure your dog goes, oh shit, let me get back to my owner. Randy threw $1.99 at us for
nice.
Happy birthday. Thank you. Next.
This one's from Aaron. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Lil Mama Mud. While advocating for my naughty dog by bonking the cat when she harasses him, I have noticed that he is calmer to me and following more. Huh. He even adjusts his positions on sits without a fight. Weird. I feel he is more respectful of me after I drove off the annoyance, or am I just grasping straws and excuses?
No, somebody had to advocate for the dog. So you did now. So that's very, very common. It's excellent. That's why we don't let people pet our dogs or dogs meet our dogs in public. Because we have to advocate for them. Good job. Probably the cat could have been a stressor, right? I mean, please. I mean, I can't imagine being stressed from too much pussy, but I guess it could happen. Next. Sorry. Had to say it. Had to do it, guys.
No.
Is
that a freaking hashtag?
I had to do it. Next.
Jasmine. Dog has staring problem with other dogs. No barking or lunging, just staring. Yep. Follows commands sloppily when she's like this. At what point do I correct?
Yeah. So the reason why your dog is sloppy is because it's distracted. Guys, remember, you do your best work when you're concentrating. So does the dog. When there's distractions, you don't hear as well. Correct? So if you're on your cell phone and you're playing a video game or you're watching a video and your spouse starts talking to you and you're just shaking your head, right? Yep, sure, honey. And then you're like, what the fuck did she just say? You know, it's like, holy shit, I guess you really are leaving me. All the clothes are gone. It's like, when did this happen? It's like, remember when you were on your phone? So, you know, it's called a distraction.
You're funny tonight.
Just tonight.
Yeah.
Cool. So it's called a distraction. So it's not unusual. Next.
Patrick. Hey guys, thank you for all you do. Jeff, happy birthday.
Thank you.
I have some awesome news. I got hired by a local dog training facility and start tomorrow.
Patrick.
Woo!
That is incredible.
Fist
congratulations.
Bump it out. Fist bump
boom.
It out.
Look at that. Kick some ass.
Melissa says happy birthday, Jeff.
Thank you, Melissa.
Marco says happy birthday, Jeff.
Thank you, Marco. I'm 53, guys, if anybody wants to know. So next.
53 and fine.
Okay, go.
Michelle, congrats on number 500.
Thank you.
500 birthday or
yeah.
Zachary, having some issues with excitement pee with my younger dog. Is this something you found puppies to grow out of? Just got his last vaccination and hoping more socializing does the trick.
Well, not necessarily. So the more socializing might make the more excitement. More excitement means more piss. So, you know, I don't know how old the dog is, number one. If you just got its vaccines, it's probably under 16 weeks. So, you know, yes, the dog is still building up its, you know, muscle. And what I find by doing a routine, don't letting the dog get overly excited, you know, unless it's, you know, especially outside, yes, inside the house, no, lots of structure, a lot of that stuff just resolves itself. Next.
Michelle says, happy birthday, Jeff.
Thank you.
Laura says, happy birthday, Jeff.
Thank you again.
Melissa says, congrats on Q&A YouTube show number 500. And hello, Mrs. Gellman. Hello, Melissa.
Thanks, Melissa.
Mark Nash.
Yep.
I just came to drop a
nice
thumbs up.
Awesome.
Josh, love the hair, Linda.
Awesome.
Why, thank you. Laura, boss. 6-month-old GSD has done a 2-hour place today following last night's show. He's back on place now, but is whining. Should I correct with the e-collar for this?
Yeah, Laura, correct for the e-collar. So whining is an active mind. We want a calm mind. It's also a pain in the ass. So whining, you correct. Now, well, what happens if the dog has to go to the bathroom? Okay, well, he's 6 months old. When's the last time he went to the bathroom? Did he just go to the bathroom? Right? Right before you did place, right before you did the show. So what I like to do is, you know, if you know your dog's schedule, but chances are he's whining because he wants to be doing something else. But right now, dogs have to acclimate to our life. Your dog should be just lying down waiting. So my dogs are in place. They'll be in place tonight from 7 p.m. till midnight. I'm going to be done with work probably around midnight tonight. I've got a lot of work to still catch up. It's been a really long day. But that's what they're doing. It's just the way it is. Like, we already did all of our active stuff today. Next.
Okay. Canine psychology. Hi, guys. From Mike.
Hey, Mike. Hey. How are you, buddy?
Allie. Happy birthday, Jeff. Thank you for donating your time to speak with all of us tonight. As always, pup on place while we learn.
It's always my pleasure. I love giving out content. Next.
Jess. HBD, Jeff.
Yep. Thank you.
I have a one-year-old male deaf bully. What's OCC?
I don't know.
Squirmy, hesitant when people come over top of his head to pet him. Yeah. He is a rock star in obedience and well-socialized. Witness him grumble slash pull away on two occasions. When meeting a new person, but snaps out of it when tapped, redirected, prong collar used. Start e-collar for this. Don't want him to associate a negative punisher with meeting new people, but want to stop grumbling.
Right. Okay. So
it escalates.
Sorry.
Before it escalates.
So, okay, guys. So what I would do is I would start doing petting protocols. First of all, people pet dogs wrong. They do. They pet dogs wrong. You know, I mean, theoretically, you should be able to pet you. The owner should be able to pet your dog any way you want to, you know, over the head, under the head, side of the head, anything you want to do. But you can ask guests to like go from underneath or tell people to not pet your dog. Right. So if nobody pets your dog's not going to all of a sudden start attacking humans. Being around humans is what socialization is. But if you want people to, I just don't trust people to make the right decision. You'll let them pet. Next thing you know, they're literally kissing your dog. I've seen it. I can't, you know, it's terrible. Or they're grabbing your dog's ears or they're who knows, they're lifting up their paw because they're like, oh my God, it looks like the dog is like got a nail too long. And next thing you know, the dog bites. I mean, people get really, really weird when it comes to dogs. So, but what you do is normally we would use food and a clicker for this. Since you've got a deaf dog, we would just do the thumbs up. So what we would do is, imagine this is the dog's head right here. You would reach in and pet and then thumbs up, food. Reach in and pet, thumbs up, and then food. And then say over the top, boom, reach. So you start counter conditioning your dog a lot of ways like that. Remote collar, though, you can do, you can use a remote collar for the low grumbling, I mean, next.
Josh says, HBD, Jeff, any word on hotel deals for the Vegas seminar?
Yeah, it is going to be this week. I'm getting a room block this week emailed to me, and I'll post it on the seminar site. We just put out three new tickets though on the seminar site. The private dinner with me on Sunday night. The videotaping of a live podcast of the What Would Jeff Do show on Friday night, and then a 3-hour Q&A of the What Would Jeff Do show for the public. So anybody can buy those tickets. So all three of those events you can get a ticket to, even if you don't go to the seminar. And then the room block is going to be, I think the rooms are like $149. The Flamingo Hotel on the weekends is not cheap. Ironically, it's like $49 during the week, something like that. But I went on to, whenever we get a room block or there's a room block, I always go on to like Expedia to be like, hold on here. Let's just make sure Expedia is not cheaper. And the room block is cheaper. It's definitely cheaper. So we'll announce that pretty soon. As soon as I get it, I'll put it up. But get your ticket to Vegas if you haven't bought your ticket yet, because that is a sellout, like most of the seminars do. $5 super chat. David, congratulations on 500, a penny for each of your thoughts. Happy birthday. Thanks. Next.
Matt, my dog and my girlfriend's dog got into a fight over a ball. What is the best way to break up a fight, and what should I do after to get them along now?
All right. As far as getting them along, I can just tell you to separate them and don't have any resources. That's not the answer. That's not realistic. But right now, I'm X amount of miles away. I'm not there. I'm not talking to you one-on-one. I can't do it through typing. So what the best way to break up a dog fight is not to have a dog fight, but that doesn't help you. Because what happens when you do have a dog fight depends on the breed of the dog. And that doesn't mean, if it's a pit bull, it's harder. It means if it's some of your bully breed dogs that have a very strong grip, lockjaw, it doesn't exist, but we'll use the word locking on just for the phrase. Because people like can envision that. Once that dog is committed to a bite and it's a strong bully breed dog, it's not going to let go. And when you pull the dog off, it grips harder. That's an innate quality in a dog that it has. That's why when you see people do bite work, they actually pull against the arm sleeve or the tug. And then dogs want to grip harder. So you have to choke the dog out. It's pretty much the only way to do it is choke the dog out. So if it has a collar on, just grab the collar. If it's depends on the collar, if it's a flat buckle collar, just twist. Or take a leash, wrap around the dog's neck, and hold it up. And you have to wait until the dog either passes out or close to passes out. Next.
comp create. Jeff just got 6-month-old rescue 10 days ago. Leash puller, got prong collar, instant fix on walking. Thank you.
Yeah. So 99% of the dog, a prong collar is an instant fix. You still want to make sure you're holding your leash properly. You've got good leash skills. You're communicating through the leash and the collar. You're not just slapping the collar on and walking. But even if you did that, that's fine. Because a lot of people are like, oh, it's prong collars are great if you use them right. It's really hard to use them wrong. And even if you use them wrong, it's not the worst thing. $20 top chat from Super Carlito. How are you? 19. Thank you so much for all your help. Use the bonker today to stop my puppy from playing too rough with my Westie. Awesome. I tested him to see if he could stop her himself, but I had to step in. Took 2 bonks for her to get the points. That I'm proud of. So I gave you advice on that, I think, yesterday. Was it yesterday that we talked? And then today you fixed it. That's what I love about this show, guys. That's why I love about the show. So, you know, like the thing about this is we have a pretty huge audience, and I know that people sit back and go, I would never do that. I would never do that. I would never do that, which is fine. Like my way is not the only way. My way is not necessarily the right way. And it's not usually my way. It's like, these are well-established dog training protocols that I'm speaking of. But if you're still struggling, but you're sitting back, not doing it, well then shame on you. And if you're still struggling with the behavior and you watch a lot of my content and you're still not trying, shame on you. What are you doing? Why are you watching the show? Right? Apply this stuff. I understand why people might not want to, because nobody wants to hurt their dog, including me. The last thing I want is having my dogs be afraid of me, be nervous, be fearful, have a bad relationship. The last thing I want with my dogs is that. But I also don't want assholes for dogs. And I don't want to have dangerous dogs. And I don't want to have badly behaved dogs. And I don't want my dog jumping up on people. I don't want my dog pulling my arm out. I don't want my dog running away and getting hit by a car. I don't want my dog to be growling at people. I don't want my dog to be getting into a dog fight either. So to me, I'm a realist. It's bottom line, I'm a realist. And I know the way the world works, and hopefully most of us do, that everything isn't fun and fantasy. And anybody that has to pay a bill in their life knows that. Anybody that has to work for a living knows that. And even if you don't work for a living, you still got a lot of other stresses out there. Next.
Marnie Cool Dog says, hi, Linda.
Hey, hello. That's great, Marnie. Cute bird on your social media today. I forgot what, there was a pigeon on Instagram, maybe.
Oh, cute.
Next. Yep.
This one's from H.A. Sammartano. Hiya. We just got a 6-month-old wire hair griffin. She is smart and feisty. Yeah. What's the best advice to help a hunting dog focus better so we can train successfully?
So the hunt dog stuff I don't do. The hunt dog stuff I don't do. But it's 6 months old. I would just do all your standard basic, you know, obedience right now. I would look for if you're going to hunt her. You know, if you're not going to hunt her, then you can just raise her as a pet. Raise her as a family pet dog. With my philosophy, but definitely want to find the dog some sort of task. And that could be anything. You could do barn hunting if you want to, or you can do, you know, I don't know, just do decoy work. But it's 6 months old. Again, the biggest thing you can do is massive amounts of structure, just huge structure. And I can't stress that enough. So especially when you get a new dog, if you just got a 2-year-old dog, structure, an 8-week-old dog, structure. But it's 6 months old. We do all, you know, at almost every age when we first get a dog, we do all food protocols, teach them what we want. We stop what we don't want. And then for severe things, we stop harshly what we don't want. And then for obedience, usually with us 2 weeks in, we start correcting for noncompliance. Your average pet home, maybe after a month of doing repetitions, you can stop for noncompliance of your obedience commands. Next.
The vertically challenged. Can you use the same method for jumping on people for my puppy jumping on my older dog?
Yeah, you can. Yep. But jumping on people, I'm way harsher. So I've got a video on how to stop jumping. I demonstrated all my seminars. I put a video out there. It's a very firm, harsh correction. I get a shitload of freaking hate on it, but I don't care because people watch that video and their dog stopped jumping. So I don't believe in working on it when it comes to jumping. So if someone says, my dog still jumps, I'm working on it. Bullshit. No, you're not. That's like saying you're working on stopping smoking. No, you're not. You're a smoker. You smoked today. You're not working on it. If you were working on it, you wouldn't be smoking. It takes 1 second to quit smoking. It takes 1 second to stop drinking. I know I gave up drinking almost 30 years ago now, but it's been about 27 years. I gave up drinking on a Sunday morning at a Tropicana hotel in Las Vegas between 11 and 12 in the morning during a champagne brunch that was $12.95. I remember the day, and I literally said, I'm never going to drink again. Haven't thought about it since. It takes 1 second to stop any bad habit. Same with jumping. It takes 1 second to stop it. Watch the video. And it should be firm. The dog will make an audible. And guess what? Bottom line, it's supposed to suck to jump. Next.
Kaylin says, happy birthday.
Hey, Kaylin.
Matt says, also happy birthday.
Guys, thank you.
Mike says, thanks for answer about prong collar not being enough for leash reaction to my dog. I'm cutting back on the beer and egg McMuffins to pay for an e-collar next month. Oh, the horror.
Yeah, well, that's probably a good idea in a lot of different things. Next. I'm not opposed to drinking. You know, Linda drinks wine. What else do you drink? What's that drink you get? The Satin Doll? That's not wine, is it?
No.
What is that?
I think it has some Prosecco in it and like an elderberry elixir and something.
Yeah. Next.
It's my special going out drink.
Yep.
All right. Sarah, my dog knows what down means, but we are still training. If he breaks, I say no and guide him back into the down. Sometimes it takes light prong pressure and other times he will resist super hard. I plan to e-collar next month or next. Sorry. How should I work through it when he refuses to down?
Okay. So Sarah, if you've been working on down for more than 2 weeks, what I want you to do is the dog gets up from a down, I want you to say no, and I want you to give the leash a firm pop, so the collar compresses, boom, like that. The dog will go, holy shit. Well, it's like, well, are we going to stay in kindergarten for another year? This isn't school. You are a dog. Let's get you out of kindergarten pretty quick. So do that. Next.
Paige says, happy birthday.
Thank you, Paige.
Oh, Noel. It's pronounced Noel. Okay. Thank you. I love seeing you in Elkhart.
Yes, it's going to be fantastic. I love it, love it, love it. Can't wait to get there.
Comp create. Hi, what can I? Shit. What?
I got shot down.
Oh, you're saying shit. I don't know what's going on.
Because I got pushed down too far.
Hi, what can I do when dog will? Wait, what can I do when dog will? Something commands with prong collar, but if I take prong collar off, she ignores command. Oh, she's getting
collar. Yeah. So how long have you been working on it? A month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, a year? And have you corrected your dog? Have you said no and then corrected? Does the dog know what the word no means? So a lot of times people don't work on commands long enough. So when we do food training, your average dog that's food trained only in obedience, it takes 4,000 repetitions to become complicit in the command. 4,000 repetitions. It's a lot of freaking repetitions. Next.
Gosh. I'm trying to figure out which one it was. How can I improve my dog Max's heel? I'm up to long lead at a park with minimal corrections with the e-collar.
So long lead meaning it's dragging a long lead? So I don't know if the dog's on leash or off leash. I'm a little bit confused. So how do you improve the heel? Remote collar train the dog to heel. And then if the slightest infraction of it getting a little bit ahead of you, start holding it accountable. Next.
The vertically challenged. What age is too young to start using the e-collar? My golden doodle pup is 12 weeks old.
Wait for 2 more weeks and just use it as a little marker and tons of food still. Lots of food. Tons of food. Next.
This one's from Paris.
Yep.
Hi, Jeff. Any opinion on the Educator ET300 Mini versus the Easy 900? The remote seems very different, but the features remain the same for a 10-month-old male GSD weighing 80 pounds.
So you're going to get, okay, the Easy 300, the Mini Educator 300, it's a different handset. So you got it's a round handset like a stopwatch compared to the longer ones like Dogtra's always done. The Easy, the 900 series is going to have way more options to it. So it's also expandable to 4 dogs, where the Mini Educator is expandable to 2, and it only has pretty much three functions, vibrate, Nick and continuous. So all depends on what you want to do out of it. I personally like the Mini Educator. Next. But as far as stim and distance, I believe it's the same.
This one's from Rob. My ACD knows place, but won't stay in place for very long. Suggestions?
So, yeah. So, again, what's the punisher look like? So, more food won't keep the dog in place for longer. So, an American cattle dog sees an environmental, they're taking off. Most dogs will. So, again, no. Leash correction, remote correction, put back into place. And then pretty soon the dog goes, oh, if I leave place, then there's a consequence. So then the dog doesn't leave place because it's afraid of being corrected. Yeah, sure. Why not? That's a great theory. I have no problem with that theory at all. When you see we're not talking about like tricks right now. We're talking about life. So when my dog is in a down and I'm in an outdoor cafe and a squirrel goes by, the hell if I want my dog to be thinking, if I stay here, my owner will say good dog and give me a pet or a piece of kibble or maybe a hot dog. Squirrel. Or if I leave, I'll get a correction that's uncomfortable. That's a damn good motivator in my opinion. Next.
Charlie, is it bad for cats to eat dog food because my parents refused to buy cat food?
I have no idea. I've got no idea. What I would do is buy cat food, take the dog food, dump it out, put the cat food in the dog food bag, and you keep just like resupplying it, and they'll think that they always have cat food. All right? And just tell them you'll buy it from now on. Next.
No. No.
I have no idea.
Dana. Yep. Happy birthday, Jeff. Thankful every day for you.
Thank you, Dana. I'm thankful for all of you.
Marnie Cool Dog has given us 3 funny smiling cats.
Nice.
Thank you. I love emojis. Garrett. Jeff, how does the mini educator work with 2 dogs and 1 remote? Not a lot of great explanation online. Do I have to cycle from one dog to another? Or can I stim both at the same time? By the way, happy birthday.
No, you can't do both at the same time. So this right here, this is dog 1. This is dog 2. Dog 1, dog 2. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Just like that. All right? Boom, boom. 1 dog, 2 dog. 1 dog, 2 dog. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Next. That is a 2-dog collar, by the way.
This one's from Melinda. Happy birthday and happy 500th Q&A. Enjoying a glass of sparkling water in your honor.
Thank you. Nice? I got some decaf going. Next.
Decaf, man?
Mm-hmm.
What's up with that? Vega. When walking my dog, should I allow him to smell the ground as he is walking, or should I correct if that's how he tends to walk forward a lot and pulls as well? Is using a prong collar my only option?
So,
I have an e-collar.
So the prong collar is going to make your life a little bit easier. So if you saw me on Instagram stories today with my dogs, and then I had Joelle's dogs with me as well. She was out of town. And what I do is, you saw they were all off leash, correct? They can pee, they can poo, they can sniff, they can roll, they can lie in the sun, they can run, they can walk, they can sit down and watch, you know, chase the rabbits. They can do anything they want to do as long as they come back to me when I call them. The walk, we're working. At my side, at my pace, head up, let's go. Next.
Tex Canine Training, happy birthday, much love.
Thank you.
Jasmine, at what point do I correct for being distracted and staring?
Immediately, as soon as you notice it. Next.
Maggie, how do I train my dog to be less afraid of other dogs? She gets aggressive and I worry she will bite another dog. I'm keeping her away from dogs she doesn't know and that she is acting this way.
So I would, just to let you know, is I would never, ever, ever have my dogs around other dogs that I don't know everything about. Never. I don't trust other dogs. So I don't let my dogs interact with other dogs. So at the training center, yes. In public, no. I would never go to a dog park. I don't trust dogs out there. I don't trust owners out there. I am skewed because of the industry that I am in, specializing in dogs with bad behaviors. I won't risk the life of my dog, the health of my dog, the training of my dog, because I wanted to see it play with another dog. So what I do is, but my dogs are around lots of dogs. There's a difference between, you can be on the subway around people, but you're not meeting all these people. So when we went to the Nutcracker, there was what, 3,000 people there, 2,000 people there?
I think the place holds about 4,000. Yeah,
I think I fist bumped three people and talked to two. But I was in a room full of people. So, you know, I can still exist in a world with humans, but that doesn't mean I have to interact with them all. Next.
Newbie says, thought you were 30. Who took the picture and posted?
My staff put pictures up. So I don't know who did that. I think Linda put a photo up of me.
I put more than one of you.
Yep. And then I think Amanda, who does some social media, she put one up of me on Instagram. I don't know if there was one up on, she probably put one up also on Facebook. And just for full disclosure, those photos were from when I'm 52. So just full disclosure. That's why I look younger than 53. Next.
Oh my God. David, 1-year-old golden, too much affection, free roaming, and lack of structured training. What training was done was by following purely positive YouTuber. Restarting training via your numerous videos.
Yeah, I mean, this is the cool thing. So I you know, I'm glad you didn't mention the name of the trainer, because I know who it is, but I don't name names, and I'm not that person. The cool thing is, there's value in every trainer out there. Number one, you either realize what you don't want to do, but the trainer in question does have good information on certain categories of dog life. Unfortunately, not like real outdoor high distraction life. But there's like, people are like, oh, I tried positive training, it didn't work. Well, then you did it wrong, because we do tons of positive training, but that's not what you're saying. So, you know, I understand what you're saying, and you're right. So everything you mentioned, I'm like, holy shit, it must be a fucking disaster. And then when it finished the question, it's like, yep, it's a disaster. So the cool thing is, you put massive structure in your dog's life, you can start bringing back more freedom. I mean, if you follow me, for some of you that are new, I travel with my three dogs in an RV. So last year I was on the road for 4 months with two of my dogs, and they were off leash 95% of the time. Like, we lived in the RV. We traveled 18,000 miles. And it's not because I'm a dog trainer. It's not because I've got these like super, super, you know, trained, high, you know, competition dogs. They're just family pets. But I'm able to do stuff with them because of structure, and then what minimal training they do have, they just do it pretty well. And it allows me, and then also my whole philosophy on dog ownership. Next.
Chalanda. Hey, Jeff, happy birthday. Took the dogs out to an off-leash walk, all on e-collars and well-behaved. We were approached/recorded and harassed by a woman who clearly doesn't have a life.
Yep, that happens.
Told her to F off and get a life. Thanks for all you do.
Good. That's always a good thing. Yeah, which is fine. I mean, you know, make sure she just, you know, just ask her to get your good side. You know, it's like, hey, can you get my good side? You know, turn around, show your ass. Does my ass look big in these, you know, pants? You know, how's my rack looking? You know what I mean? It's like, just have fun with it. Just have fun with it. They'll get frustrated. Next.
Vega, my dog has started to pee when sitting down. What should I do about that?
Oh, I don't know. Tie it in a knot. I mean, you know, I would need more context. So is it nervous? Is it fearful? Is it afraid of possibly getting a correction? Have you been too harsh with it? Is it too excited? Is it anticipating something else? There's a lot of variables. Check it for a UTI. Next.
Lil Mama Mud says, bah-ha-ha, cat's a new pussy here, so can't blame her for his previous behavior, but hope this new attitude stays. We'll keep chasing off the pussy. He ignores her, so I am happy.
That's good.
Enough with the pussy.
Hey, man, she's from Canada.
The thing is, your behavior just encourages people to come on here and act just as crazy as you do.
Okay, next.
Chiba. Working with a dog on remote collar recall, dog comes, but just kind of goes past me. I use a long line to give guidance.
Yeah, so you're getting drive-by. So what you do is this. Get yourself a disc. Get yourself a, you know those, if you go into your any tack shop or any feed store, they have those black rubber bowls. They look like a dog dish, but they're made out of rubber. Turn them upside down. They're great for stepping up on. Retrain the dog to recall front paws on that. and look up at you. Do that. Or front paws on it and sit. So do start doing recalls to sits, recalls to sits, recalls to sits. Try it on a 6-foot leash first. Next.
David, can you explain what you mean by layering the e-collar versus teaching command with e-collar?
Sure. So layering the e-collar is we train dogs on a leash first, leash and prong the command. So sit, down, place, and walking on a leash, and then usually recall. But usually recall, we go right to the remote. And then we do it with a pressure on, pressure off theory. So, you know, teaching a down, leash pressure down, teaching a sit, leash pressure sit. And then when we layer the remote, we use the continuous button at a working level, which is the lowest level that the dog feels. So it's like, yep, I feel pressure. And then we do pressure on, pressure off with the remote. So that's what we mean by layering. Next.
Laura, you mentioned in your place videos that you don't care if they sit, stand, or spin around as long as they don't leave. Is sleeping an issue, or should I just take the win?
No. So, Laura, let me rephrase that. That's a really old video. It's probably when I first started doing place. No, I want dogs to go to place and lie down. Sleeping, that's fine. No, if they thought they're allowed to sleep. Like my dogs are, you know, so for everybody that's on a sound platform or is visually impaired, I apologize, but I'm holding the camera up right now and I'm showing three of my dogs. All in place. So they're all sleeping and they're not tired, by the way. It's not like, you know, they're tired. They're just like, this is my philosophy. What else would they be doing? They're going to be here for hours. But of course you're going to go to sleep. There's nothing else to do. There's nothing to be seen here. Next.
Sebastian, how do you start your dog on a raw diet? Happy birthday.
Go to MindFart. What is it? Raw Pet Nutrition? Holy shit. I talk about them all the time. Pet.nutrition.com. I mean, pet.nutrition on Instagram. Ask, go to the next question. Go to the next question, hon.
Chiba, happy birthday, by the way. Thank you for dedicating both of your personal time to us all.
Yeah.
Hey, no problem.
Pet.nutrition. Oh, I don't know if that shows up. Yeah. Pet.nutrition. Pet.nutrition.com. Just go to them and they'll help you. Next.
Jess says, yes, absolutely. I can pet my deaf pup anyway, and he has no issue whatsoever. He knows thumbs up as his marker. We'll start the protocol. Started some e-collar today and he really responded. Thanks.
First, Chiba, thank you so much for the well wishes. And then good job on with the deaf dog. And just remember, you don't have to have people petting your dogs. Like, nobody pets my dogs. If you were at the training center and you were out in the rubber room with them and it's like, and they came up to you, it's like, you can pet my dogs, but like in public, no, leave my dogs alone. Next.
Pam, Andy is 8 months old now, knows place command, but breaks place often. Procedure for correcting with remote collar, correct?
So what
correct
I would
correct higher than working level or at working level and timing for correction?
No, it's you correct. It's what we do. Everyone does a little bit different here. We do a momentary correction higher than the working level that makes the dog go. It's a correction. It is a punisher. Oh shit. Yep. And then at the beginning, you still have to lead the dog back to place. So ideally, when you say no, you say it calmer. No, I was just trying to, for some reason I was enunciating. No, hit correction, boom. Eventually the dog just goes back. But now you have to lead the dog back. So you still want to have that dog on a leash. Next.
Create. If you toss bonker at dog to correct bad behavior, what do you do if dog then takes the bonker?
Then you tossed it wrong. Then you did it wrong. And you're not tossing the dog. You're throwing the bonker extremely hard at the dog. It should scare the shit out of the dog. Yep, we use fear. So, you know, the last thing the dog should want to do is grab that bonker and play with it. It should go, oh my gosh, I didn't like that. And it shouldn't see it coming. It shouldn't see it coming. So it should be extremely, extremely firm. Throw with force. It's a cotton towel. You're not going to hurt your dog. Next.
Super Carito.
Yes.
Yes, I asked about it yesterday. It was awesome to see her get it. And after just laying down together for like 10 minutes, they went on to play without any problems.
That's a classic example of dog training working right there. That's a classic example of you teaching right there. Perfection. Good job. Next.
This one's from Rose Montave. I'm taking care of my sister's German Shepherd, and we got along well together from the beginning. However, she growls and gets into fights with my pit mix whenever she gets near me or the front door. Hold on, there's more. They don't fight unless my dog does this.
So, okay. I'm not sure which one is resource guarding you. One of the dogs is resource guarding you. If it's the German Shepherd, that's total bullshit. So be careful about building too close of a relationship with a dog that you're watching. So what I would do, because I'm not there, you have to keep them separate. I don't know how long you're watching. If it's for the next year, we should probably do a Skype and figure it out. If it's just for a couple of weeks, keep them separate. Crate them up separately. So, you know, again, that doesn't fix it. But to me, I don't want them fighting. So the advice I can give you right now is to keep them separate. Or what you'll do is you can start having one dog, say, in a crate, give the other dog affection, swap them out, show, and then don't let the other dog get agitated. Don't let the other dog. We have very strict protocols on how to fix that. Too long to get into on this show. But right now, unless we did a Skype or you did a Patreon or something like that, I'm not trying to like get you to spend money. But whenever it comes to biting dogs, I'm not going to give you like a casual answer. It's like, just separate them for right now. But that's not the fix. Next.
This one's from Amanda. Happy birthday, Jeff. I've trained my 1.5-year-old lab mix consistently since puppyhood, introduced e-collar properly, yet corrections cause her to whine more and more, specifically while on place. Tips?
Yeah, I mean, almost all of my advice is, you know, wide blanket paintbrush statements that work for most dogs. And then you've got some nuances there. So what's happening is you could be underwhelming the dog. It's driving the whining farther. That means sometimes you've got to go higher, but also you can also bonk the dog too. You can bonk the dog. Whining is annoying. So it could be your dog also anticipating. It also could be your dog not its mind is not at rest. You want to work on more duration work. We had a dog that we couldn't stop from whining. It's unusual because we deal with a lot of whining, but you know, it still happens. So you have to get creative. Got to get creative with it. Next.
This one's from Eddie. So I use prong collars on my two pit bulls, 11 months and 10 months. Yep. They both have no problem with me putting it on. But when it comes to taking it off, one is so afraid that she pees herself. Any pointers?
Huh. Interesting. So that's usually the opposite of what happens. So what I would do is I would do some food protocols. When you take it off, are you pretty fluid on getting it on and off, or are you struggling with it? Are you saying anything? So what I would do is this: videotape yourself taking it off. See what's going on. Critique yourself. Be like, huh, geez, I didn't know I was being so sloppy or, you know, manhandling the dog or anything. But it also could be excitement. Is the dog excited that now it gets to run around? You know, it could be that. There could be some different variables there. Next.
This one's from Kaylee. Continuing to work on my dog's whining when he knows we're going for a walk while we watch tonight. It's slow going, but progress over perfection.
Nice.
John says, how far do you let your dog creep ahead of you before correcting?
I don't let my dog creep ahead of me. I want my dogs behind me on the walk. Next.
Caitlin, I have a German Shepherd and she will be a year old at the end of the month, and she is fearful of people and new dogs in public, and I don't know how to build her confidence. What should I do?
Yeah, a year old, they go through different fear stages. What you can do is, number one, you know, this is the thing. A lot of people have a hard time working their dogs through fear stages and working their dogs through fear in general because they feel bad for the dog. The best thing you can do is teach your dog a damn good heel and get your dog to not worry about the rest of the world and only worry about you. And remote collar healing your dog is able to tune out the world and really focus on the task at hand. When a dog is focused on the task at hand, it tends to tune out the world. You can also do, you know, training protocols in public with food. But if your dog is that afraid, it won't take the food. So you can do that. Also work on confidence building, under things, over things. Go to children's playgrounds. Get the dog into agility. Next. A $5 top chat.
Yeah.
ComCreate, watching all your videos over the past week, very appreciative of you. Thank you so much. Lots of work with new puppy, but your advice really works. Yeah, puppies are tons of work. Congratulations, that's awesome.
Next,
sorry.
Caitlin, I have a German Shepherd and she will be a year old at the end of the month, and she is fearful of people and new dogs in public, and I don't know how to build her confidence. What should I do?
You already did that one.
I thought we didn't.
Yeah, no, we didn't.
Oh, shit, sorry.
Next, Jacob.
Jacob, why didn't you tell me? You should have interrupted me. Hoping to go to the DePere, Wisconsin.
Next.
I probably would tell you to shut up.
Exactly.
Hoping to go to the DePere, Wisconsin seminar to work with my dog on her interactions with other dogs.
Yeah, we'll do dog.
Can't wait.
We do dog. Yeah, get your ticket. That one's going to be a good one next. They're all going to be good ones, but that's my first time doing it out there. It's my first time in Wisconsin. Next.
I am fostering a Yorkie Chihuahua, one-year-old female who pees constantly when excited or picked up. I try not to get her excited or use a high-pitched voice, and she still pees. Help, please.
So what I find is this. We don't directly. So first of all, don't try to not get excited, get her excited. Don't get her excited, and don't use a high-pitched. Never get her excited right now. What we find is, by putting the dog in a structured program, by not getting excited like that, by holding the dog accountable, by having a good system in place, creating the dog, lots of rules, lots of structure, excitement and nervous pee just organically goes away. We never address it directly. It just fades away. Next.
You just got a top chat there?
Top chat, $10. From Deb Damiano. Just wanted to wish you a happy birthday and thank you for all the free content. My four dogs are better behaved thanks to you. Deb, super proud of you. Super proud of everybody, by the way. Next.
Comp Create says, I know you suggest Educator 300, but see cheaper collars at pet store. Get what you pay for, or are these suitable for alternatives cheaper?
No, they're not suitable at all. No. Get the least expensive one I would ever suggest is the Mini Educator. Next.
Sean. Hey, Jeff, I have a Belgian Malinois. What is your opinion on your dog's laying / sitting on the couch with you?
I mean, Sean, you can spoon with your dog. It's your dog. You can do anything you want with it. But what's the behavior? What are you struggling with? How long have you had the dog? So you don't have to answer these questions right now. So if you've got a dog that has separation anxiety, you shouldn't be doing it. If you've got a dog that is leash reactive, shouldn't be doing it. If you've got a dog that resource guards, shouldn't be doing it. So any major bad behavior, whether it's anxious whining behavior or like physically lunging, biting behavior, or a dog that's snotty and blows you off, it's not a good idea. But again, I'm not opposed to sleeping with your dog. I'm not opposed to dogs on furniture, but what else is going on in the dog's life? And usually at home, dogs are relatively good. Okay. How about in public? How's your dog? So then it's up to you. All I know is this. More love and affection does not fix unwanted behaviors. It never has and never will. If it did, that's what we would do. Next. Karen, GSD
lover. Karen, GSD lover. My dog ignores the word no, did high stim, and he respected the word for a while. Is punishment the best way to teach the word no, or is there another way?
If you want no to mean a punisher, yeah. I mean, if you want no to mean good job, you would use food. But if you want no to mean the literal meaning of no, don't do that, it has to be a punisher. So what's the consistency? Is it no and then high level correction? If it's just if it's a suggestion, the dog takes it as a suggestion. If it's a proper punisher, then it works. So if you're saying no to your dog and it doesn't stop, It doesn't know the word no. No is just an English word. You can use any word. You can make pizza the worst word in the world. You can make pizza mean no. In non-English speaking countries, they don't say no. They say another word. So it's whatever word you put to it. But as far as there's theoretically two ways to train a dog, reward or punishment. That's it. Take your pick. So if you reward, the dog will like think that they're supposed to do it. So you have to use a punisher. Next.
Vertically challenged. 12-week-old golden doodle tries to eat adult dog food because he free feeds and can control his intake. Advice on how to stop pup from doing this. Love your vids. They helped us crate train in 3 days.
Yeah, let's fix that right now. You end up with a fat dog. So the other dog shouldn't be free feeding. Or it should keep its food in a crate and eat in a crate. Or else you will end up with a fat dog. So how can we do it? Yeah, I can do it. I can make it suck to go over to the other dog's bowl if you want to. But I'm a realist. Stop leaving the food down. Next.
Ashley, any advice for a dog with seasonal allergies?
No idea whatsoever. That's not my level of expertise at all. Go to a vet. They'll tell you to change dog food. Switch to the raw diet. Do that. But I don't know anything, you know.
But if it's seasonal allergies, that's not going to do
anything. Is it seasonal allergies, though?
Right.
Is it seasonal allergies?
Maybe it's not.
A lot of medical stuff I don't believe in. I think it's a bunch of bullshit.
What, when it comes to dogs?
Yeah. Or? Well, it comes to humans, too. Just like the vaccination stuff. Exactly. So, next.
Allie?
Yep.
Kind of specific question, but on our walk tonight, a raccoon popped out from under a car and postured at us. Raji growled. She has had no leash reactivity otherwise. I corrected, but wondering if it was the right thing to do in the situation, or would you not have corrected? She didn't. I think she's saying she didn't break heel.
If I was walking my dogs and a raccoon came out from under a car and postured and my dog growled, I wouldn't have corrected it. But that doesn't make you a bad dog owner, Allie. Don't freak out. Mm-mm. Okay, you're fine, but I'm saying, like, that's fine. It's no big deal. Next.
John, do your dogs play fight with each other so you correct this behavior or just let it go?
No, my dogs play fight to the maximum. So Girl and Kira, they play fight like you'd think it was a fight. Like, I mean, we're talking like I've got great photos. I've got a fantastic photos of them play fighting. You'd think it was a death match. Oh, absolutely not. I let my personal dogs play fight with each other. I know exactly what they're doing. I know their limits, and I can say enough, and they immediately stop. Like, we're talking immediately stop, like lights out, like the room all of a sudden got dark. So that's how quick they stop. So no, I absolutely let them fight. Now, they can't fight inside the house. They can't fight inside the car. They can't fight when they're on a walk, but when they're out in the play yard, let them. When they're running out in the field, let them. Oh, I don't care. Next.
Bentley, what would you recommend for a dog bark collar that works? I was also wondering how to stop my dog from whining constantly. I have tried to shush him and he won't stop.
Yeah, because shush it's a worthless. Shush doesn't mean shit. Shush.
It might mean shit.
You know what I mean? So you don't shush him. There has to be a punisher. So shush, the dog just goes, I'll whine more. For all you know, you trained your dog to whine more. For all you know, seriously. If I wanted to, I can train a dog to whine and shush is the cue. I can say shush to my dog and it whines. I mean, that's what dog actors do, right? They whine, they show their teeth, they roll over, they give a paw, they limp, they piss on command. Do you know what I mean? That's what a dog actor does. So as far as bark collars, dog trot or e-collar technology, sport dog makes a different one, good one, and Garmin. So you got four choices there. Next.
Comp create, 6-month-old Griffin, does playful puppy nipping, no aggressive biting, do not yet have e-collar, best way to correct, bonker?
Yes. Next.
Riley, firstly, thank you for sharing your abundance of knowledge, tips on a dog that never showed gun shyness, then developed a huge fear, won't take food, even though very high food drive, 48-hour fast, won't tug.
Yeah, so that's going to be a hard one. You're going to have to start all over. What I would do is I would get a soundtrack. They do this for hunt dogs, of just literally gunshots going off, started at a really, really low. You can't force the dog to take food. You can't force the dog to tug. Gunshots at really low volume, start increasing the volume, and just do all kinds of different, try doing food protocols eventually. Next.
This one's from Sophia. Been working on place for a while with little improvement. Each time dog gets off, I say no and give prong correction. Should I use bonker as well? Eventually, I want him on place when guests are over.
Yeah. How long has she been working on it for? Like
a while.
Yeah. I would say your punishers are probably not high enough. Punishers are not high enough. Also, with a gun dog, I would talk to a sport dog trainer or a canine trainer. I would talk to them, or a hunting trainer. Talk to a hunting trainer. I would look up hunt dog training and ask someone there. I bet you they've got great protocols, way better than me. Next.
Top chat.
Top chat. the candid millennial. Can you crate train a dog that's almost 8 years old? I have a fear-based aggressive dog. Never knew how to train or start using your tools. It's helping. Not sure if it's too late for crate. No, the candid millennial, you can absolutely use a crate. If the dog came to us for 5 week board and train, it would be in a crate on day one. And the whole crate training thing about 10 minutes at a time is bullshit. No. Good night. Go in your crate, or go in your crate. Good night. I'll see you in the morning. Any noise, I correct you. Simple as that. Next.
Jeff the Chef, this is a little random, but I've noticed almost all trainers use the word here for recall instead of come. Is there a reason for this?
I don't know. I like the word here because I think I think the word here carries better outside. Mm-hmm. Next.
What would you expect from a board and train with a good trainer? How much can they do in 3 weeks?
All depending on the dog, all depending on the trainer's skill set. What does good mean? It all depends on the dog and that environment. You know what I mean? So usually 3 weeks, it's basic obedience on a leash, starting to do off leash. But your dog, what happens if your dog gets dropped off in the first week, it's afraid, not because of the trainer or the facility, just because it's like goes into a fear state for a week, doesn't eat. You never know. But a good, at least on leash training, I would think. Public access and on leash training. Next.
Flipper Swooper. My dog is still being pushy on walks and inching out in front of me on walks after multiple 180 moves. I'd like him just behind my knee on walks. How can I tweak this to get him to stay in position?
So what you do is this. When you're walking your dog, say your dog's on the left, dog forges ahead, take your left foot, heel tap him in the chest. Boom. I'm not telling people to kick your dog. It's a heel tap right there. You ain't going to hurt your dog. It's the sternum. Just heel tap it right there.
That reminds me of that movie. Wolf of Wall Street. Yes.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Didn't he lose like 40 pounds for that role?
Yeah.
Yeah. Something like that. Next.
Megan. Happy birthday. My 6-year-old recent rescue follows me everywhere. If he is not in the same room as me, he will whine and bark. He is fine when I leave the apartment. Also want to work on personal space. Any advice?
Yes, Megan, the place command. Look it up. It's on my website, on my YouTube channel. Look it up. Next.
Stephanie, finally saved enough and got a 2-dog e-collar. Training is already going wonderful with it. So happy and just wanted to say your videos encouraged me to stop being afraid and just do it.
Yeah. Yeah. Stop being afraid of shock collars, guys. You're not going to hurt your dog. The reason why you're not going to hurt your dog, because you're afraid of hurting your dog. Next.
Little Mama Mud says, sorry, Linda, but I have poor verbal diarrhea. I don't need an excuse to get dirty mouth. I blame my father.
No, she doesn't. Next.
What? Who doesn't?
Rebecca in Canada.
Okay.
When it's 40 degrees, when it's 40 degrees, negative 40 out.
Look, let's just clear something up here.
What?
I've got a mouth like a sailor, and we know this, right? Yeah. So I just want to let you know, little Mama Mud, I was just kind of joking.
No, she does. Plus, she's Italian, so she gets angry. Next.
John, do you ever use touch pads in training? What is the purpose of the exercise?
No, we don't. I mean, it's good for positioning. It's good for possibly future tasks the dog is going to do or work the dog is going to do. You can send your dog to a spot and stand up or sit down or lie down. And it's good. It's good for concentration. But you know, give it a shot. Have some fun. Next.
Megan walks dogs 3 times a day. Female gets all 3 free walks. Male only gets 1 free walk. Will chase rabbits when dark out, not if light out, so he's leashed. I'm working on e-collar training him.
Nice.
My question is, I know it's important to get at least 1 structured walk in. Should the female be in a leashed structured walk at one point?
If I lived in the country and I had tons of land, or even not tons of land, if I had an acre, I probably would never take my dogs for a walk. I would just have them run around outside doing stuff. So just to give you a heads up, I barely walk my dogs anymore. I run my dogs all the time. When our pool is open, which is open about 8 months out of the year, I swim them 3 or 4 times a day. I don't walk. I walk my dogs. Last week, I walked them once. I walked them last Saturday morning. This weekend, I walked them Sunday morning. because Saturday was raining really, really hard. Other than that, I just run them every day. Next.
Hi, Jeff. Follow up from before. You know what? I'm losing my voice. Hold on a second. Follow up from before. Understand about not trusting random dogs, but I have friends who have dogs and I trust them and I know they aren't aggressive. Yep. I try to introduce my dogs to my friends, my dog to my friends, dogs. I live in Colorado.
Yep.
So we go camping, hiking, climbing, etc.
Yep.
I want for her to be able to hang with other dogs without getting in fights. Thank you.
Oh, no, no. I agree 1,000%. 1,000%. What? Oh, Linda's got to go. It's an hour show on Mondays. So I'm a huge, like, I have no, like, your dog's allowed to be with dogs. I'm not saying never allow your dog to meet dogs. I'm saying never allow you to meet, have your dog meet dogs you don't know, and especially on a leash. So, but as far as like meeting dogs, socializing dogs, I'm a huge advocate of that. Huge advocate of that. So, you know, we've got today, I don't know if they filmed it or not, we had 15 dogs doing a socialization session at our training center. These are daycare dogs and boarding dogs, but none of those dogs should be meeting dogs on the street, but they're all hanging out together. So, all right. All right, guys, Monday, it's a 1 hour show. Wednesday will be on at 8 o'clock. It's a 90-minute show. Thank you all. There's still time for you to go onto our IG stories and post a question underneath your IG stories. Then also, you can also go onto my Patreon account, post a question there. And I'm sorry I didn't get to everybody's question. It's hard. It's hard to get it to all the questions. All right. We're having more and more people show up to the show. So love all of you. Take care. And thank you for all the birthday wishes. And keep following our content, Instagram, Facebook, obviously on YouTube as well. All right. Thanks everybody for the continued support. I really appreciate all of you. Take care. Bye-bye.